So what we're going to do now is we're not going to assume we compound every year, but we're going to assume we compound instead every month. Now, here's the significance of this. Most of the time, when you talk, when we're talking about banking, everything is compounded monthly or sometimes daily. But generally, if we're talking about mortgages, if we're talking about loans, things are compounded monthly. Interest rates often are compounded monthly too. Now, the rates that you're going to see that are published on bank are actually yearly rates. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to kind of translate the yearly rates into how much that means during a single month. So here's the deal. Let's start with $5,000, and we want to gain 8% yearly interest. Now, if I compounded monthly and I waited just 1 month, how much would I have? Or how much would I have in the account? How much interest would I gain? Okay? So here's what you have to do. Still, you're going to start with your $5,000 in principal. And still, if I'm trying to find out how much is in the account, I'm going to take 1 plus my rate. Now, what I have to do is understand that if I'm talking about 8% yearly, well, if 8% is done yearly, then basically I need to take 8%, I'm going to take that as a percentage, 0.08, and I need it to divide by 12. Now, clearly it's 12 because there's 12 months in the year. So 8% divided by 12 is actually going to be my monthly rate. So if I wanted to wait for 1 month, I put the exponent of 1. Now, I will say this. Don't try to round this number. This 0.08 divided by 12, it's much better if you just type this into your calculator. Type in 1 plus 0.08 divided by 12. And then take the exponent and then multiply it by 5,000. In fact, this is one that is actually easily put in your calculator if you remember to keep these parentheses. So type in 5,000 times parentheses 1 plus 0.08 divided by 12 in parentheses, and then take your exponent of 1, that caret key with the 1. And we see that the amount in our account would be $5,033.33. $5,033. Again, if I calculated that right. So that's how much would be in my account. That means $33.33. of interest. Now I want you to be very mindful of this. This was, we said, how much would you gain in 1 month? So we had this exponent of 1. If we're talking about more than 1 month, then we're going to have to change that exponent. So the basic idea is, if we're talking about compounding monthly, we're always going to take 1/12 of the rate. Whatever the rate you have, in our case it was 8%. We're going to take that 8%, 0.08, divide it by 12, and that's going to become my new monthly rate. So the idea is this 0.08 over 12. That's the real secret. All right, so let's do this. Let's Start with 4,000, gain 4% interest. How much would you have after 3 months if you compounded interest monthly? Now, by the way, I should probably mention that anytime I talk about gaining 4% interest or gaining 10% interest or gaining 8% interest, we're going to assume that you're given the yearly rate and that rate is a yearly rate. And so when we translate it into monthly, we know we have to divide by 12 or take 1/12 of it. So I want you guys to try this on your own. All right. Again, you should have pushed pause. If you didn't, then we'll start back up and you can push pause right now. But with what I talked about earlier, so we're going to take the $4,000 times 1 plus 0.04 divided by 12, and we're taking 3 months. So that's a 3. Again, all of this should be able to punch into one line of your calculator. So you should be getting better with your calculator by this point in time. And we'll see that after 3 months at 4% interest, we have $4,040.13. Now here's the change. So far I've given months, so my exponents have all been in months. But if we have this $4,000 into an account, $4,000, and we want to gain 4% interest, and we want that 4%, we're going to compound monthly. So I know I start out like that. How much would you have after 10 years? Now be careful here. The exponent should not, I repeat, not be a 10. In fact, the exponent, remember, is what we're talking about is the number of months since we divided by 12. Now, how many months are in a year? 12 months are in a year. So, in 10 years, there's going to be 120 months go by. So, the exponent here should be 120. And if you do this, and if I've typed it into my calculator correct, $5,963.33 is the amount that should be in that account after 10 years. Now again, if I'm asking for interest, then it would be $1,963.33. And it turns out you get this for your monthly interest formula. Now again, A is the amount in the account after any certain period of time. P is once again your principal, that's your starting amount. 1 plus, we've seen the rate over 12, since we're talking about months. And this exponent, I called it 12T, and in general it's written that way, where T is the number of years. So if it's 15 years, then you're going to take 12 times 15, or 180 months. So the exponent is really the number of months. T is always written in years. All right, so I want you to start with $853.45 in account. Assume it gains 5% interest. How much after 10 years, or how much would you have after 10 years if we compounded the interest monthly? I want you to type this in and calculate this for yourself. All right, if you're not done yet, then push pause, but I'm going to move on. Basically, what we're going to do, just like before, $853.45. That's my principal. 1 plus my rate, 5% over 12. And since it's 10 years, that's 120 months. So I'm typing this in my calculator. Probably should have done that before, but that's okay. And if I've calculated this right, you should get that in the account will be $1,405.64. And again, if something doesn't make sense to you, go back to a previous slide, but that's where we're getting that. Again, that 120 comes from 10 years, 12 months per year. All right, lastly, I want you guys to try this. Start with $118,400 in your account. And instead of 10 years, you're gonna have 5% for 20 years. So push pause, try this, do the example yourself, and then come back. All right, so starting with $118,400, I'm going to take 1 plus, so we're getting 5% compounded monthly, and the exponent here, 20 years. 20 years means 240 months, so my exponent is going to be 240. And if you type that into your calculator, you should get 321,176.61. And by the way, we're going to do some observations about this. Notice that after 20 years, we gained quite a bit of money. And that's how interest works. And if you leave it in there longer and longer times, you're going to get longer and longer. You're going to get more and more amounts of money. Okay? So we'll do some comparisons of how you can manipulate the amount of time, and you can manipulate the how often you're compounding, and you can manipulate your interest rate, manipulate your principal, and see how that affects our things. And that's in the next section.